Sure. My name is Niraj Chavan. I am originally from Mumbai, India, and I'm in the University of Kentucky as a clinical fellow in the Division of Maternal Fetal Medicine, Department of OBGYN. Right now we are in Dr. Pearson's lab in the Department of Pharmacology and Nutritional Sciences at University of Kentucky. My lab experience and my lab experiments have typically been directed towards the field of fetal programming, which basically means trying to understand how various exposures that happen to a baby as the baby is still in the uterus, and trying to see how that actually affects the long-term growth and development. This is specifically very important when it comes to public health problems such as diabetes or metabolic conditions that can actually affect the long-term growth and development. And in a laboratory setting, we're trying to understand how each of these various exposures that happen even before birth can actually tell you or predict how you would do when you're growing up, say 5 years hence, 10 years hence, or even 50 years hence. And so the whole purpose of that laboratory experimental setup is to try and simulate or recreate those scenarios and try and understand how we could potentially actually change those in a favorable way so as to prevent disease in the long term, decrease the incidence of obesity, decrease problems such as cardiac issues, morbidity associated with cardiovascular disease and obesity and metabolic syndrome in the long run by actually looking at what happens at the very beginning, even before you're actually born. Being originally from Mumbai in India, that's where I grew up, and I did my medical school training in Mumbai as well. I do come from a family which has inherently a science background, with my mother being a professor in biochemistry and my father as well having an original background in biochemistry and life sciences, but later on branching into the industrial and commercial side of science. And that being the case, I was sort of motivated naturally, inherently, towards pursuing science as my long-term career option. I think what inspired me the most was the questions that remain unanswered on a day-to-day basis. We see human disease in many forms, and therefore at the end of the day, when you're trying to answer these questions and seeing, is treatment A better than treatment B, or is there a way that we could prevent a medical condition altogether and therefore have something that could be introduced as a preventive strategy, each of these various aspects of improving the human health experience is what science inherently answers. I think the biggest achievement that I could say for the future of our work is to gain national recognition and to be able to actually come up with remedies or solutions that could actually help to change how health and disease is perceived in the long run, how we could potentially bring in small little changes, like for instance exercise for pregnant women in the case of diabetes, and if this could potentially help in preventing long-term diabetes in the neonates or in the offsprings. Such sort of easy to adapt and easy to sort of accommodate interventions, if we could come up with those and have these implemented on a national basis and see if that can actually down the line 15, 20, 50 years later help to improve or decrease the burden of disease by that token.